ancient animal gods and goddesses eventually evolved into cult animals associated with a humanoid deity such as Athena and her owl, Odin and his ravens, and so on. As people matured in religious and spiritual expression, ancient human sacrifice was replaced by animal sacrifice. Animal sacrifice evolved into plant sacrifice as the hunter-gatherer society became an agricultural society. In the case of Dionysus, his blood was the wine from the grape and his body was the vine. The divine king became the harvest lord, killed at the time of his ripened grain. He is known by many names, such as the Green Man, John Barleycomb, Hack Seahood, or Jack in the Green. The ever-repeating theme of this concept is renewal. This renewal restores divine herbi not only to the soil to replace what the crops have consumed, but also to the lives of the people. By consuming the divine king before the passing of his prime, each individual came away with their own inner natures revitalized. In many cases, the sacrificial body is burned and the ashes scattered on the earth. In agricultural societies, the ashes were scattered over plowed fields to ensure the fertility of the soil. An old European custom still practiced in some places is to burn effigies of mythical figures at the closing of the year. It is important to note the magical associations of burning an effigy connected to agriculture. Heat and light are essential to the growth of a plant and to its production of fruit or grain. The fire represents the sunlight and moonlight that first gave birth to the agricultural deity. Just as the plant goes to seed and dies, only to produce another plant, so too does the god die so that he may live again. Therefore, the harvest lord returned to his source, completing the cycle of all things. In a nature religion, how could it be seen any other way? Magical links and the nature of subcultures to retain inner symbolism have created many important cultural traditions. It is quite common in Europe today to see the remnants of pagan worship displayed in agricultural themes. The harvest queen, or kern baby, is one example. In this tradition, the last sheaf of the harvest is bundled by the reapers, who proclaim, "We have the kern." The sheaf is then dressed in a white frock decorated with colorful ribbons depicting spring, and hung upon a pole, a phallic fertility symbol. In Scotland, the last sheaf of the harvest, called the Maiden, must be cut by the youngest female in attendance. If the harvest is not completed by Samhain, Hallowmas, then the last sheaf is called Kaya or Old Woman. Just as the kern baby was hung upon a pole, the Kaya, also known as Kailik, is traditionally hung in the barn. When the first grains have been ground into meal, a portion is placed in a barrel and mixed with ale and whiskey. Farmers invited to the meal and ale celebration all partake of their fill. Once in a thoroughly festive mood, the farmers go into the barn and dance beneath the kailik. This type of celebration is traceable to the ancient Roman harvest festival where celebrants danced beneath effigies of Ceres, the goddess of grain.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.